Hello friends, in this video we are going to see two different arrangements of a register, and that is star and delta. Sometimes in a circuit it is very difficult to observe series and parallel connections, meaning it may happen that there is no series and parallel connections given directly. But if you do a small change in the circuit, you will definitely get number of series and parallel connections available. For that purpose, we need to study two different topology of the resistances. And those topologies are nothing but star and delta. Till now, we have seen series and parallel connections with the help of which we have calculated equivalent resistance between points A and B. So see, every time we were focusing only on two points. But this particular topology required three points. So star will look like this. So I will name this as A, B, C, and I will name the resistors RA, RC and RB, and here I am getting one more point which I will name as N. Similarly, delta, again three resistors. I will name the resistors . Let's analyze this circuit. First of all, whether it's a star or delta, it's telling about three resistors combination. So it's very important. It's talking about the three resistors compulsorily. It's not like a series and parallel where you can have n number of resistors. Delta and star, strictly speaking, about the three resistors combination only. So how star is distinguished from the delta? Whenever you are having one end of each resistor connected together, forming one more junction or one more point, then that particular connection is called as a star, right? So I can say one end of each resistors connected together, that particular topology I will call as a star. Delta, three resistors are connected such a way that one after the other, so that it is forming a loop. So I can say three resistors are forming a loop, then those three resistors are considered to be connected in delta. What is the advantage of star and delta? We have seen series and parallel combination, and now we are seeing star, which can also be represented like this, and delta, which you can represent it like this. Series and parallel combinations always reduce the circuit. So the advantage of series and parallel reduction of a circuit. But as I said earlier, sometimes it is not possible to figure out how many series and parallel connections are given, but slight change in the circuit, you may get number of series and parallel connections. So that change can be provided by star and delta. So star and delta, rearrange the circuit such a way that after using star and delta, you may get number of series and parallel connections of resistor. Hence, ultimately, you can reduce your circuit into a one equivalent resistance between points of interest. So we will see how we are going to use this star and delta in order to rearrange the circuit, which eventually leads into a series and parallel connections in order to get a reduced circuit between points of interest. Thank you.